EDSvideo.com. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. It's been a little while since my last video. I want to do a couple of x-rays, CAT scans, and different kind of clinical pictures. I got tremendous feedback from you all that you liked the way I did it. So let's get ready. I'm going to find the last set of pictures I have here, and we'll move through those. All right. This one's a patient who presented to the emergency department with just swelling of the hand. No trauma. It was warm, it was swollen, it was tender to touch. Clinical scenarios, differential diagnosis includes cellulitis, like an infection, abscess, but there was no focal fluctuance anywhere. Arthritis, if you have gout, it would present in the joint, redness, swelling, and so on. But that was pretty much it. There was no clinical history of fever, chills, no review system was otherwise negative. So our clinical impression was cellulitis. Patient was put on antibiotics and sent home. The antibiotics used were Bactrim to cover for MRSA type cellulitis. And then I did also Keflex to cover the other bacteria associated with cellulitis. This one's a little kid who fell on her elbow. And the important thing to notice here is something called the fat pad. And you can see here the posterior fat pad, which is swelling on the posterior of the elbow. And whenever you see a fat pad, your clinical suspicion goes really high for something in fracture. So even though we don't see a fracture on that particular view, let's go ahead and change pictures. This is the x-ray. And if you follow this line for the bone all the way through, nice and sharp all the way through, maybe here a little something. When you follow this other line right here, you can see a clear change in the cortex. That right there is a supracondylar fracture. It's a fracture above the condyle. And these are very dangerous because of a complication called Volkmann contracture, in which a patient can have a compartment syndrome damaging the blood flow to the rest of the arm or the nerves, and so on. So there are three grades of supracondyles, 1, 2, and 3. 2 and 3 are clearly surgical right away because of this complication. Grade 1, we just put on a splint and discharge home. This kid sustained the injury while jumping on the trampoline. Those trampolines, I've seen so many injuries this week from trampolines, you know, spring coming out, kids getting out to play, and so on. This one here is a bad one. Look at this x-ray. This is the left side, and you can see the darkness going all the way through the edge. You can see the border of the heart very nicely. You can see the diaphragm edge right here. So this side is normal. Now we're going to change colors and do maybe a red. On this side, you lose the right side of the heart. There's none. You can see this all white here. That's either an effusion or pneumonia. It could also be a big hiatal hernia, mostly on that side, because you can see, I'm going to erase this here, you can see right here almost like a bubble of air. Or it could be an abscess underneath. So we don't know. Usually when we see such an abnormal x-ray, and we don't really know, we can do a lateral view to see if that settles. When the patient lays down, the fluid would kind of, when the patient would lay down, the fluid can set like that, and then you know it's clearly an effusion. If it doesn't settle, then it's either an empyeme, which is a localized thick abscess in the lung tissue, or a pneumonia, and so on. All right, let's do another one. This is a patient that presented to the emergency room. This was a known diagnosis, but look at this. There's all these lesions right here, right here, right here, right here. These are all metastatic cancer. And this patient known to be cancer, but right here, I'm going to erase this, and I'm going to show you. This area right here seemed to have gotten bigger from the last time we did an x-ray on him. So we think that on top of the cancer, patient also had pneumonia. And it could be an obstructive pneumonia. Whenever there's a mass or cancer obstructing the bronchiole, then mucus and plugging can set in, and infection can set in, and patient get pneumonia. It's a very interesting x-ray right there. This one was a patient who was playing with a shotgun. Don't ever do that. And shot herself in the foot. This was accidental. But you can see right here, there's a lot of tissue destruction. You can see all the little pellets everywhere. You can see the fractures of the toe there. The toe was actually kind of hanging. And there was exposed flesh, exposed tendon. This patient went to the operating room just to wash out the tissue, get as much pellet as they can, but not to repair it until you know what's viable. You got to wait 1 or 2 days to know what tissue is viable, then clean up again and fix it. You can see probably multiple midfoot fractures. So that's going to be a bad repair, bad healing, and chronic problems with that foot for this young patient just because they were playing with a shotgun. This is the same patient on the lateral view, and you can see the cracks of the bone, foreign bodies everywhere. So very interesting x-ray. This patient had a fracture of the base of the fifth metacarpal, and you can see the fracture right about here. And he had some repair with pins, and he presented to the emergency room because the hand was all swollen and red. He could actually push a little discharge coming out. So we did some cultures on it. We put the patient on IV antibiotics and admitted the patient to the hospital. He actually ended up signing out AMA against medical advice, mostly because he wasn't getting the pain medicine he needed. Patient's a young patient, already on Medicare, Medicaid, and all that stuff, and disability and whatnot. This is a young patient, also jumping on the trampoline, went and rolled her ankle, and you can see, go ahead and pause it if you like, try to figure out where the fractures are before I tell you, but definitely you can see right here, it's a little fragment, and this is called an avulsion fracture. Avulsion. In other words, the tendon got stretched so hard and so quickly it chipped the bone out. And we think over here there's a fracture as well. So this patient was put on a U-splint that goes around like that and then ties around with ACE wraps and referred to the orthopedic doctor for repair later on. You can see the chip fractures right there. This is the radiologist reading of the same. This is a very interesting x-ray. Remember we talked about just before about the posterior fat pad and that increases your likelihood of there being a fracture? Look right there. This is very obvious. That's the posterior fat pad. But in addition to the posterior fat pad, we get an anterior fat pad right there. And that one's called the sail sign. Almost like the sail of a boat. And whenever you see that, there is a fracture, even if you can't see one. But now that we know there has to be a fracture, we highly suspect a fracture, let's find it. The most commonly missed elbow fracture in a kid is a supracondylar, which we just showed you. This is an adult. The most common elbow fracture missed is a radial head fracture. And I'm going to zoom in first, and then I'm going to show you the fracture. Bam, all the way, way zoomed in. And right here, you can see that it's not smooth anymore. There's a sharp edge right there. That's the radial head. And that is the fracture right there. So patients put on a splint and referred to orthopedics for repair. Probably won't repair it. They just put a splint on for a while. All right, I'm going to zoom out. And we're going to change pictures. That's the kid. Ooh, this is a... Okay, that was my little girl. And this here is hematochezia. Hematochezia stands for blood in the per rectum, and it's bright red blood per rectum. Hemato stands for blood and chezia. This patient had a colitis, an infection of the colon, and was having bloody bowel movements and a fever. He had a past history of cervicolitis, so he was admitted to the hospital. This one here is a patient presenting with severe eye pain. I mean, she was crying and screaming. No trauma, no history of welding, exposure to UV light, does not use contact lenses. And then look right here. This is after fluorescein staining, which is a special dye for the eye. That's a large corneal abrasion. Normally all you can see is a little line like that, a little scratch like that, but this is huge. So patients has to, tetanus needs to be updated, put on antibiotic drops, put on Cyclogel, which is a dilator and fixes the eye open so it doesn't keep contracting when it's exposed to light. Obviously, pain medicine. Lots of pain medicine, extremely painful condition for the patient. And wear sunglasses, no eye patch. We don't do that anymore. And referral to the ophthalmologist. These generally heal 50% in 24 hours, another 50% in 48. So they're usually done in 3 days. But this needs to be followed very closely because they can get infected. They can heal with scar tissue and therefore decrease her vision. Number three, after a couple of days, she could scratch it and pretty much like a scab, dislodge it, and then the healing has to start all over again. This is a video on the same patient looking into the camera and so on. All right, this is a good one. Pain at the bottom of the hand. He punched a tree, but he punched it not like this. He punched it like that. And we'll have to zoom in to look at the fracture, but I'm just going to show you right here. And I'm going to erase that so you can see it again. That's the fracture right there. So a patient's put on an ulnar garter splint, ACE wrap, followed with orthopedics for permanent cast placement, or maybe even surgery. Sometimes they have to put pins. This patient was driven over by a car. His nail was actually bent almost 90 degrees straight up. You can see the shadow of the nail right there. But what's really important is the fracture line right there. Right there, there's a fracture line. So nothing you do for toe fractures. You just put a skull body taping. You tape the toes together. You give them pain medicine, and eventually it'll heal. Nothing to do with this. I think that's it for now. We'll do some other x-rays later. See ya. Bye-bye.
EDSVideo.com. Thank you.